Welcome into the Week 12 College Football Special of the David Hookstead Show. It is another wonderful Saturday in America. We have a full slate of college football games today. They're going to be a ton of fun. We have a few things we're going to break down here, but I'm really excited. It's crazy to me that we're already in Week 12. We only have a couple more weeks of the regular season left. Then we're into the championship weekend. Then we're into bowl season. It went so unbelievably fast. Feels like it was just the middle of June or July. We're talking Heisman favorites. We're talking preseason rankings. And now we only have two games left for our teams. It's crazy to me. It's been a fun ride. I've enjoyed every bit of it with you guys. And we're going to take this strong through the finish line, through these last two regular season weekends, conference championship weekend, and then the bowls. So the first thing I want to talk about is the playoff rankings. I know people are really pissed because Cincinnati's not in. I just want to double down and say Cincinnati right now does not deserve to be in. I don't think Cincinnati's that good. I don't think they've beaten anyone other than Notre Dame that is any good. Anyone that even has a pulse. They've played Navy close. Tulane played them close for a large portion of that game. They're just not impressive. You put them on the field with Georgia, Alabama, Oregon, Ohio State, Michigan, Michigan State. They're going to get dog walked right off the field. It's going to be disgraceful. So everyone complaining about the playoff rankings and complaining that Cincinnati's not, that's not what you should be mad about. The only thing you should be mad about is the fact Michigan State, who beat Michigan head-to-head, is ranked 7th and the Wolverines are ranked 6th. That's ridiculous. If head-to-head play doesn't matter at all, what are we even doing here? Why are we even playing the game? So that's my thoughts on the rankings. And I touched on that earlier in the week, so I don't feel like I have to hit it too hard right now. What I do want to talk about, though, is the biggest game of the day by far, the biggest game of the day is Ohio State versus Michigan State. Noon, ABC, I believe. They're playing in Columbus. We're going to get into that in the spread action. But here's what I'll say about this. This game is for the Big Ten East, essentially. If Ohio State wins, they're going to beat Michigan. At that point, they're in the Big Ten title game, probably playing Wisconsin, which we're going to get into in a second as well. If Michigan State wins and they win out, they're going to be in the Big Ten title game. Assuming, of course, that Ohio State beats Michigan next week, which I 100% fully expect to happen. So this game has, without question, the largest stakes. It is the most important game. This is not just for a Big Ten title, potentially. This is for playoff position because the loser of this game is out of the playoff conversation. The winner of the game is in complete control of the Big Ten and has a path cleared for them to the playoff. This is why we play the sport, folks. Michigan State, Ohio State, 4-7. This is why we play the game. This is what people get out of bed for. This is what amps people up. These are the games people talk about for years after the fact. And I know Ohio State is a big favorite. I expect this game to be very close. I think Kenneth Walker, you got to remember, Michigan State's defense is not elite. I'm sorry, Ohio State's defense is not elite. Elite offense, CJ Stroud has a great arm, but their defense is liable to get crushed, as we saw in the Oregon game. I think Kenneth Walker won't have that much trouble putting yards up on the ground. We'll see what happens. That leads me to the other side of the Big Ten, which is Wisconsin-Nebraska this week. Now, Wisconsin, you can see with the helmets behind me, and you can see with the old famous Wisconsin football up there. Wisconsin, we went out. We're in the Big Ten title game as a 9-3 Big Ten West champion. We'll be playing likely the winner of the Ohio State-Michigan game. And I just want to take a moment to remind everyone who said Wisconsin would never be here at the start of the season when we were 1-3, who said Wisconsin's football program was dead, tried to stick us in the ground, put us in the morgue, burn the carcass. That's what they wanted to do to the Badgers, and now we're 7-3. We're playing a Nebraska team that we're going to, quite frankly, beat the shit out of today. That is how I feel. And I know everyone's like, oh, it's gun season in Wisconsin. Gun season starting, deer season. People aren't going to be at the game. Look, it doesn't matter. We're going to roll the Cornhuskers, okay? And I want everyone who talks so much shit at the start of the season to remember this. I want all of your notes. I want all of your receipts. Keep that same energy. When you were talking trash on October 2nd when we lost to Michigan and we were 1-3, don't let up now. Keep that energy when we're winning the Big Ten West. Don't let up. Keep it coming. Everyone has gone so silent. It's weird. My Twitter used to be full of people who just would not stop trashing the Badgers. And I was as upset and angry as anyone at the start of the season when things weren't going well. But I stayed true. I kept the path. I kept fighting. And all these people who couldn't stop running their mouths at the end of September, start October, they're nowhere to be seen. They're hiding more than Osama bin Laden was. It's easier to find Osama bin Laden back in the day than it was to find all the Wisconsin critics who have seemingly disappeared from the face of the earth. Well, don't worry about it, because I kept everything. I kept my notes. I kept the receipts. And all I can say is when we march in Indianapolis, and when, I got to be careful, when we march in Indianapolis, I'm going to make a prediction later when we get there. When we march in Indianapolis, don't think for one second, I'm going to let anyone forget how it went. We're 15th in the playoff ranking. We could be top 10 by the time the Big Ten title game rolls around. We'll see. I just want all of you to know, I did not forget. And you might pretend like you forgot, but just know, I damn sure did not. All right. Let's go into the gambling picks here. Now, the other week we had a lot of success. Very happy about it. Here are the gambling picks right now. I'm going to read them off to you. We're going to break it down. Ohio State, Michigan State. Ohio State's favored by 19. I'm taking Michigan State on the plus 19. Like I just said, this game is going to be way closer than people think. Way closer than people think. 19, to me, that seems like easy money. Give me the plus 19. Oklahoma, minus 3.5 over Iowa State. I like Oklahoma to bounce back after losing to Baylor. They needed a reality check. I like the minus 3.5. Alabama, minus 20.5 against Arkansas. Give me Alabama again. I just see no way. I like Arkansas. I like Sam Pittman. They got a good QB. They got a lot of, you know, they got a nice front seven on defense. They're a talented team. The reality of the situation is Alabama, though, is just too good. Give me Alabama, minus 20.5. Cincinnati versus SMU. Cincinnati favored by 11. I like SMU at plus 11. Like I said, I think they're fraud. I think Cincinnati's frauds. Absolute fraudulent actors. I said this about Iowa State, but it applies to Cincinnati as well. Cincinnati's bigger frauds than half the women you see on Instagram, okay? Nothing you see with Cincinnati is real. They're frauds. That's all they are. They're fraudulent actors in the college football world. Colin Collard likes to call Iowa the fake ID of college football. Well, compared to Cincinnati, Iowa's got nothing on them. They're the fake ID of all fake IDs. Frauds, give me SMU plus 11. I love that line. Nebraska, Wisconsin. Wisconsin favored by 9. I'm taking 9 all day. I might even buy that line up into like the plus, the minus 14.5 range. I think Wisconsin is going to kick their ass today. So anyways, it is another great day of college football. I couldn't be more excited. I'm actually headed up to the Naval Academy today with Armed Forces Brewing. They're doing a little event up there. I'm going up there to see them. I'll let you know how it goes after the fact. I'm super excited. I haven't been to Annapolis since 2018, actually. I went for the Caps outdoor game. I think they're playing the Maple Leafs. For those of you who have not been to Annapolis and have not been to the Navy Academy grounds and have not been to the football stadium, it is absolutely gorgeous, absolutely beautiful. It's a great American city. It's on the water. You have so much pride that you have there because it's the Naval Academy. It's a military town. You just love America. So I'm going to go watch Navy play some football today for this event. I'm super excited about it, super pumped. And I will see you all on Monday for the next regular episode of the David Hookstead Show. Drink a few beers for me, fire up that grill, and let's have ourselves an amazing Saturday at college football.